Welcome back to the score. Galing natin ito. With the entry of 3X basketball in the Southeast Asian Games, our two teams came out on top. For the men's division, the Philippines defeated Indonesia 21-10 in the finals after going undefeated in the preliminary rounds. In the women's division, our team would bounce back after a shocking loss to Thailand to win in the finals against Thailand, avenging their only loss 17-13.
That was exciting, I guess. There was the whole redemption story na talagang it was their only loss, and then suddenly, may nakuha na nila ulit yung panalo eh. So parang at the same time, it was even sweeter as we said it a while ago because, yes, that loss doesn't matter because at the end of the day, we got that gold.
Yeah, that loss, ginalit eh. Ginalit yung ating women's team na para, okay, when we meet you in the finals, we are not going to let it go.
And that's why I think we have on our phoner one of our guests to talk about this great game, none other than, of course, Coach Pat. Coach Pat?
Yeah, good evening.
Good evening. Congratulations on the win. Yeah. Coach, parang tuloy-tuloy na yung panalo nyo. Can you let us know, what are your tips and, the secret for your winning success in the women's basketball?
Well, I'm just happy with the girls na they really work hard for this and just happy with what they did today. And sana it would continue to the 5-on-5.
Tama yan, Coach. No, your job is not yet done. Oh, pero Coach, NU 6-peat, 96 straight victories in the UAP, and now gold medal in the SEA Games 3X. Coach Pat, baka kailangan magpakain ka na, Coach. Walang katapusan ng iyong pagpapanalo.
Anytime, but yung natutuwa ako dun sa mga tinagawa ng mga girls natin. Kasi talagang yung sakripisyo at saka hirap na ginawa namin for the past few months, ito na yung goal for them. So talagang masaya ako for the federation, yung Sir Ad, Sir Sunny, yung Sir Ryan Gregorio, and to the management of the Pilipinas, talagang who are really at our back supporting us all the way.
For Coach Pat, I wanted to know, nung natalo yung women's team dun sa Thailand, did you think they used it as fuel when they went against the team in the finals? Or wala, it was just another game to them being in the finals?
Not really. It was like a wake-up call for us. So, it's a good thing that we lost, but at the same time, sayang.
Yeah.
But, nakita namin kung ano yung mali namin, and the next time na makalaban namin siya, we know what to do with it. We should do na. So, buti na lang din na nagkaganon. So, nakita ng mga girls na alam nila, kaya naman nila. So, ginawa lang nila yung talagang gusto lang magawa for the game.
Coach, let's talk about Jack Daniel and Imam. Alam mo naman na si Jack ay aking favorite UAAP player of all time. Ikaw ba, nahirapa ka bang pilitin si Jack because she's coming off an injury? In fact, she probably played in pain. Ikaw ba, nahirapa ka bang pilitin siya maglaro sa 3X for the SEA Games? Or si Jack talaga is such a fighter and competitor na, no coach, I'm not going to sit it out. Gusto ko lumaban dyan.
Yeah, wala akong masabi sa kanya. From what happened to her in New Zealand, she was left behind because of her injury dun sa parang may fracture siya dun sa skull niya. And then, when she came back, she was really ready and she missed us. So sabi niya, I miss staying na coach. I wanna work out na. And then, before the start of the tournament, pinagbawa na pa yung mask niya. So talagang hindi namin alam kung ano gagawin namin. So sabi niya, no matter what, I'm gonna play coach. So sabi niya, okay. Kaya, bilib na bilib ako dito sa bata na to, and talagang puso yung ginagawa.
Pero Coach Pat, how was the celebration like after you got that gold for the team, for the girls, for you?
I can't be my stuff. So, from the federation, what there, the management, talagang tuwa-tuwa. We were crying, everybody was really, this is for the women's basketball. Sana man, sabi ko mga kanina, sana mapansin naman kami, sana ma-recognize na kami ngayon na not only the men's but the women's basketball also.
Well, for the record, Coach Pat, kayo ang unang pinag-uusapan namin ngayong gabi. Mamaya na sila, Papa Ronnie and the men's 3X team. Coach Pat, yes, yes. Why should Filipinos be inspired with the accomplishment of Jack Animam, Claire Castro, Afril Bernardino, and Janine Ponteos? Why are these athletes inspiration for Filipinos?
Well, maybe siguro for the longest time, hindi napapansin ng women's basketball. And ito na yung sacrifice na yung all the hard work na ginagawa nila for the country. So we just hope na this is the start of something big for women's basketball here in the Philippines. So yun lang, sana tuloy-tuloy lang yung suporta sa akin. And I think mas marami pang mga ganito makukuha namin for our country.
Coach Pat, you know, what are the, you know, future plans for the team? Do you have any competitions up ahead, maybe to practice for more competitions abroad?
We hope so. There are lineup for tournaments for next year for the FIBA TXT, and we're hoping na yung ginawa ng men this year for the qualifying for the Olympics, sana tayo rin, kami rin, yung women's side.
Okay, Coach Pat, alam ko si Coach Pat, ano na yan, ha? Naghahanda na yan for the 5-on-5 naman. Coach Pat Aquino and the rest of the team, Coach Pat, mabuhay po kayo and congratulations.
Yeah, thank you so much again. Maraming salamat po para sa bayan po to, and thank you ulit sa mga support and your players.
All right, Coach Patrick Aquino, head coach of our victorious women's 3X team, Jack Animam, Claire Castro, Afril Bernardino, and the sweet shooting Janine Ponteos, one of my idol shooters now in basketball. Congratulations po sa inyo. Now, men's side man, let's talk about that 3X victory, Coach Ronnie Magsanok.
Sweep.
They swept it. Syempre, you know, this is expected kasi syempre, basketball is our sport in the Southeast Asian Games, but
what is basketball without Filipinos?
Yes, but it doesn't mean that it was easy, right?
I think, you know, with our athletes, with winning all the gold, the beautiful thing about it is what, you know, what Agatha said a while ago, we only see when they win the gold, but what matters the most is, you know, all the sacrifices that they go through in getting that gold. And I, for one, am very curious to know that sweep did not, as you mentioned a while ago, did not come easy. And I want to know the story behind it.
Well, we will find out the story behind it because, so again, congratulations. CJ Perez, Mo Tautua, who has a nice three-point shooting touch now. Chris Newsom and Jason Perkins. So yan yung ating victorious 3X team. Naturally, they had to deal with pressure kasi everyone who watched that at the Phil Oil Arena, inaasahan nila na, oh, Philippines, dapat tabakan nyo yung mga kalaban. Dapat hindi walang makakadikit na mga Southeast Asian teams. And that's incredible pressure for a team to deal with.
But, you know, they are veteran players. You have Jason Perkins, CJ Perez. They're champions in their own right. Talagang nandun yung winning mindset and yung mentality na, you know, the crowd, the pressure might be there. But at the end of the day, they're athletes. And it's all about winning the game despite all the noise.
Yeah, CJ Perez destroyed someone with a slam dunk in the 3X. Wow, CJ Perez with one of your memorable moments in the SEA Games. And what our women's and men's team, what they did is really setting the tone for basketball. So we dominated 3X, and now ang ngayon na pinagdadasalan tao that this augurs well for our 5-on-5 team.
That's right.
Under Coach Tim Cohen. We have one of the members of our gold medal team in the 3X, Mo Tautua, on the line. Mo, good evening and congratulations, Mo.
Thank you.
All right, Mo, hey, I saw your three-point shot, man. I saw that. Are you going that's not lucky. Are you going to take more gold medal winning three-point shots on the court?
Of course, man. If they leave me open, I'm taking it. No hesitation.
Mo, I wanted to ask, you know, what were the struggles that you encountered during the game? I'm sure it wasn't smooth sailing, but, you know, how did you get past it?
You know, one of the things that was hard for us out there was just making sure we're fresh. We had to move a lot. We're running a lot. We have a lot on our mind in terms of our scouting report. So the rotations that Coach had us in and keeping us fresh, kept us sharp on the court the whole time.
Mo, what do you want to tell all the Filipinos who were cheering for you in Phil Oil and cheering for you all over the country, praying for your gold medal win today?
Man, I want to say thank you, all of you guys. You guys really helped us, really pushed us through to the end. And, you know, I love you guys. Thank you for supporting us. You know, we do it for you guys, and we're going to continue doing it for you guys, huh?
All right, Mo Tautu, gold medalist, part of our 3X men's basketball team. Mo, once again, thank you for joining the Score, and congratulations.
Thank you, thank you. Take care.
And now we continue with all the medals that we've been racking up. The Philippine water polo is back on the podium after an 8-year medal drought. So now we will be sitting down with the members of the Triumphant Squad when the Score returns.